Growing up in church, I had to think a lot about my body. I had to think about what I wore and how I presented it to other people. You know, I had to be mindful of the male gaze and anything that could happen to me because of what I had on or what I looked like. But what I realized is that men didn't have to do that. They didn't have to be held accountable for what they put on to make sure that everything was okay and no one was looking at them like they shouldn't be. What's that about? Because of that, I ended up being a person that was kind of uncomfortable in my own body. I had issues with affection and intimacy. And then it made me really have an issue with the word sexy. Like, was it okay to be sexy? Was it cool to be sexy? I just feel like women have such an unfair burden placed upon them simply because of what we look like. And I'm just wondering, is it fair? I don't know. I'm figuring sexy out. We'll see. When we talk about women feeling comfortable in their own bodies, you know, it makes me think about all the attention that we get. Some of it wanted, some of it not. You just wonder, should I be sexy or should I not? I think about something that Tiffany Haddish said. She talked about how she says things to men to objectify them, to make them uncomfortable, but really to make them think about what they're saying to people, right? So they can think about what is coming out of their mouth. And then there's the women that do want to feel sexy, like Aisha Curry talked about. You know, she said, yes, I'm a wife, I'm a mom, but I'm still a woman. I'm still feminine. I want to look good. Honestly, I feel like I fall somewhere in between. Some days, I don't want you to tell me what I look like. Mind your business. And then some days, I'm like, hello, you didn't see me? I think it's something that I have to work on and something that I'm really just still trying to figure out. What I realized, honestly, it's about creating your own definition of sexy. You get to decide what it is. Now, I've been called sexy a lot, and I haven't always received it well because of the negative connotation the word has in my mind. I know. But what I also realize is that whether I have on a bikini or a turtleneck, somebody's gonna notice and somebody's gonna tell me. So I'm really gonna start taking my notes from Megan Thee Stallion. I love it. She walks through life not giving a fuck, and I'm cool with that. Whether or not she has on booty shorts, camo pants, jeans, she's always gonna be seen. And why? Because she exudes confidence. She's okay having the body that she has. She's okay with people noticing that. And that's something I wanna do. It's on my 40s before 40 list, to embrace my sexiness, to own it. So you might ask, Leslie, how am I supposed to do that? I don't believe it. I've got just the plan. It's real simple. We just say thank you. That's it. I'm just gonna say thank you. So whether or not I believe it, I'll say thank you until I do. And that's something I'm gonna work on. So, you know, maybe I don't feel sexy today, but tomorrow that may change. Either way, thanks. I'm getting there.